Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of the Correct Book Diary. We are bringing a lot of pens and refill stations to the schools today.
Oh, 478 correct boeken gaan we vandaag uitdelen.
478?
Ja.
We hebben zoveel pennen mee.
Volgens mij niet.
Op die post stond dat er 15.000 werden uitgedeeld.
Ja, in totaal worden er 15.000. Alleen dat kunnen we nooit in één week, zeg maar.
Oh.
Get up the stuff we use for distribution of the correct book sets. Now we meet Marleen and then we go to the school.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh.
Our 500 books, and we are now at the headquarters of the Anglican Church, which is our new partner for distribution, the 50,000 books.
Is toch echt wel? Heb je het zelf bedacht?
Ja. Yeah.
Goed man. Echt heel slim en eigenlijk heel eenvoudig, hè?
Ja, klopt.
Eigenlijk
ja,
heel,
heel eenvoudig, klopt.
Maar heel, heel.
Het werkt.
Heel, ja.
Nice.
Je moet eigenlijk niet te moeilijk denken.
Nee,
dus.
Nee klopt. Nee, dat
is echt, ja,
dat is het leven.
Uniek.
Je moet niet te moeilijk denken.
Ja, dat is zo.
We are now in the Rimera Protestant School, which is located in the heart of the capital city, Kigali. And we are here to see the difference between a school in the city and a school in the remote areas.
De eerste school die we bezochten was de school in de stad. En dat was dus de school die al best wel wat verder was. Die ook iets meer middelen heeft voor de kinderen om te schrijven, te lezen, et cetera, et cetera. Ik merkte dat de kinderen heel erg goed Engels praten. Dat viel mij meteen er gewoon best wel op. Ja, het was best wel een soort van modern eigenlijk.
First met the teachers and then there was a lunch break, so all the children, like 2,000 children, were were crossing the street and were coming for us. So it was like a mosh pit and everybody was screaming and yelling, and so it was quite a happening.
This is what you call a warm welcome.
I have 24 books.
New books?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And 3 pens and 2 books. 2 books of English, mm-hmm, and mathematics. My father works in the office.
And mama?
And my mama sells clothes. I want to become a singer because it's my talent. Lord, we praise you, for we love you. You are good, you are good. Lord, we praise you, for we love you. You are good, you are good.
They did have the writing materials, books, pens, not supported by the government, but supported by their parents.
And I think that's the difference between a school in the city and a school in the remote areas. And therefore, I think that Korrekboek is more needed in the remote areas.
We're now in a classroom where there are laptops, so the students can learn their words and all courses with a laptop. And what's very important to get these laptops by the government is that they have cameras, they are very well protected, so they can be sure that they are safe here and that the study will be at best with the laptops.
We are now in the room of the head teacher, and he asked us to be here to sign the visitor's book. And to sit down for a bit. The pen is empty, so I cannot write anymore. Which is quite ironical for that.
If there was only a way, you can just refill them.
Exactly.
Bless them. I do thank you for the visitors from Holland.
Ja. Maar ik vond het ook gewoon goed.
En heel erg bedankt.
Goed geslaagd.
Ja, zeker.
En goed.
Doeg.
Doeg.
We are driving in this big Land Cruiser to the school Gi Cha Cha. There are more than 1,000 children at the school, but we are handing the Korrekboeks out to about 500 children to the lower primary school because they have to practice a lot. They are at an age they do not have to remain the notes in the notebook yet. So we think these children will need the Korrekboek most.
So, though I come, we don't need the only handout. But if people should need it for their development, and then maybe after 1 or 2 years, the community can be involved in buying much more books. And then, yeah, we need to think about that. We plan ahead.
When you have 3 levels, nursery, primary, and secondary, the secondary section has to take their lunch at school. And you see that here we have a very small kitchen, those are the firewood, and then in the middle of the time, 1 p.m., they are taking their lunch at school. After the lunch, they come back for studies. Yeah, it's not easier.
Not
easy. We struggle. It's not easier. Some can afford, others can't.
Yeah.
So in Rwanda, we have 4 categories of people. Someone in the first category is for free. The student can take the lunch for free because the government and the community has to support. The second category and the third category, they are struggling so much, but they can pay a little bit. But no one can be excluded because of you didn't contribute for lunch.
No, exactly. No.
that is how Rwanda is about making one community and sharing.
Oh.
We're now in the library of the school, and I found these exercise books. But one of the things is that they cannot bring them home, and they can use them once. So I already proposed that it could be a really good idea that we also make practicing books so they can practice some assignments multiple times.
We welcome you, our visitors. This is Group Scolaire Gichacha. So we thank you so much for joining us and also having this heart to our community. So for performance, the school is improving.
As Correctbook, we have the great dream to find solution for illiteracy. They were asking also hard questions to us, which for me gives a good sign, because if they are asking for difficult questions, then they are taking it serious and not see it as just a gift.
And now the last question. So my last question is about children.
We're gonna distribute the correct books in the classroom.
You can write on the book.
And then you can erase it with a red cloth.
We hebben de boekjes uitgedeeld in een klas. Dat was wel heel erg leuk om te doen. De kinderen kennen het hele concept natuurlijk nog niet. Dus er werd ook echt uitgelegd hoe je het moet gebruiken. En het is natuurlijk eigenlijk aan de school hoe ze dit verder gaan toepassen met de leerlingen.
Wat me vooral opviel was de blijheid van alle kinderen, ongeacht of ze op een stadsschool zaten of op de school waar dus echt arme kinderen zitten.
Vooral de camera's heel erg interessant. Als je het klepje zeg maar naar hun draaide, dan vonden ze het helemaal fantastisch dat ze zichzelf konden zien. Dus dat vonden ze alleen maar heel erg leuk. En ze knuffelden en ze zaten aan met tatoeages. Het was allemaal natuurlijk gewoon een bezienswaardigheid voor hun.
We thank you for this big gift. And help.
We are now with five people here in Africa, and sometimes it's hard to believe that it is working. It started 5 years ago and it is working now.
Yeah, excellent.
Yes.
Yeah, I thought the founder is like someone with two hairs, you know, two hairs, gray hairs.
Ja. Het was een onverharde weg met nog wat kuilen, stenen, geulen. En wij reden in een stadsauto en de auto voor ons had een mooie hoge voorwieldrijf. Ja, dat ging niet altijd even vlekkeloos en we moesten ook echt uitkijken dat we de auto niet beschadigden. De chauffeur had nog niet zo heel veel ervaring, maar het was een hele aardige man. En er waren wel wat diepe kuilen en geulen waarvan ik zeker wist dat hij er niet door kon. En toen heb ik maar even geholpen. En ja, het was een beetje hand- en spanwerk, maar met z'n allen zijn we heel huis teruggekomen. En ook de auto was helemaal heel toen we terug waren.
Ja. Ik had het niet gedacht. We just left Gichacha School. Just on time because it's becoming to storm and rain now. We are driving on a very bumpy road, so hopefully we will make it. But I just heard that in Africa we don't have problems, we have challenges.
Africa is only challenges.
Thank you.